Dear friends and flight students, in today's video, I'll show you the easiest and fastest way to determine a holding entry procedure. After watching this video and training with my given examples at the end of the video, you'll be able to determine the entry procedure in less than 10 seconds, I guarantee you that. Why do you need to know this in the first place? During your flight training, you'll practice a lot of these entries, but even more important, if you're facing a simulator screening during an airline assessment, flying the correct holding entry is a minimum requirement. So train this well and you'll make a good impression on your flight instructor or screening examiner. So let's get started. Let's go. Okay, before we get right to it, there's one thing I highly recommend. Print out this little compass rose for your training. It's a great help for you to visualize finding the right entry procedure. The link to this rose is in the description box below. So now you're in your plane and you receive the following ATC clearance.
Speedbird 125 heavy, hold northeast of Joe VUR on radial 045 at 6,000 feet until further advised.
So let's break down this clearance. Now the call sign first, obviously, then the ATC controller advises you in which cardinal direction you should hold over the fix. Northeast. So imagine a holding fix on a map, draw a north to south line and east to west line where the lines cross is your holding fix, and then determine the northeast sector. Now he then mentions the radial you should fly on, in this example 045. Keep in mind radials are drawn away from the station, so draw a line from the fix heading towards 045. Now he didn't state which direction to turn within the holding. This indicates a standard holding, meaning right turns. So draw a curve to the right, starting at the fix, continue with a line parallel to the radio, which represents the outbound leg, and then complete the holding with another right turn towards the inbound leg. Okay, now you've visualized the holding, and the most important thing you need to extract from your visualized holding in order to quickly determine the entry procedure is the outbound course. So in our case, the outbound course is 045. Now, it starts to get interesting, but it's very easy, don't worry. So let's say you're flying towards the Joe VUR on heading 120. Now use your little compass rose or your actual heading indicator in your plane, draw an imaginary line from the middle towards heading 120. Then use your right thumb, because we're requested to perform right turns in the holding. So put your right thumb at a 90 degree angle to your current heading, so 210. Slightly move it upwards so that the bottom part of your thumb matches the 210 and your thumb covers 20 degrees above the 210. Draw a line from that point diagonal through the center to the other side of the compass rose. Now you can see you've divided the compass rose into three different parts. Now memorize, above your thumb is the teardrop sector, opposite your thumb is the parallel sector, and below is the direct entry sector. Once you've established that, you then place your outbound course into your compass rose, so in our example 045, check which sector it's in, and bam, you've got your holding entry. So in our case, it's a parallel entry. Boys, it doesn't get any simpler than that, trust me. The best thing about this technique is if you're in your plane, you only need to figure out the outbound course and if it's a holding with left or right turns to use your thumbs accordingly. If you're supposed to fly a published holding presented in a Jeppesen chart, the outbound course is even published in the chart, making things even easier. Also, if you're to fly a non-published hold and the ATC controller says hold on radial 230, for example, that already is your outbound course, because in a holding you fly to the VUR and radials always leave the VUR. So just copy the radial course parallel to the inbound course and you have your outbound course you need to quickly determine your entry procedure. So let's fly a holding with left turns, a non-standard holding with the following clearance.
Carbolux 284 heavy, hold southwest over Diekirch VUR on radial 210 at flight level 140, left turns.
So he more or less already told us the outbound course, which is 210, and we're proceeding on a heading of 270 towards the VOR. So let's quickly use our thumb rule with the compass rose. We draw our heading 270 line. Now we use our left thumb because we're doing left turns in the holding. So 90 degrees to the left of 270 is 180. Cover up the 20 degrees with your thumb, draw the diagonal line across, and again apply the memorized rule. Above the thumb is a teardrop, opposite is the parallel, and below is a direct entry. Place your outbound course into your rows and bam, you got it, a teardrop entry. Don't forget the bam is important. The same applies to NDB holdings, but be alert during the ATC clearance, the controller may say,
Airdrill 125 hold over Bottrop NDB on QDM 330 until further advised.
A QDM is always flying to the station. Use this mnemonic to memorize it. A QDM is always flying to the station, so you're flying home, and flying a QDR, you're flying from the station. Concentrate then on figuring out the outbound course again and then apply your thumb rule. So now I'll give you a couple of examples to train this thumb rule. I'll fade in ATC clearances, the holding fix, and your plane's current position with heading. Then pause the video, apply what I've taught you, and then press play as soon as you've done the math and check if you're right. Keep in mind, if the ATC doesn't mention the direction of the turns, it's a standard holding with right turns. As you can see, it's fairly simple once you get the hang of it, and there are more holding clearances to use for training on my website. Just click the link in the description box below. And in the next video, I'll explain how to actually fly the entry, how to maintain within the holding using wind correction angles and a stopwatch. So make sure to check it out. Thank you very much for your time. I hope you enjoyed this video, and don't forget, a good pilot is always learning. See you next week. All the best, your Captain Joe.